400,000 of our jobs rely on it, either directly or indirectly. $100 million a day tourism is worth to us, or was. Rebuilding it is essential if as many of those jobs as possible are to be saved. Joining us now is Tourism Minister Kelvin Davis. Minister, it's nice to have you with us. Thank you. You said the industry, this is in the media statement that you issued yesterday responding to the news of Level 2, the industry has a lot to look forward to as we start to get our country and our economy moving again. It does. Level 2's a start. But the message we're getting overwhelmingly is it's not enough.
Yeah, first of all, John, let me just acknowledge the tourism industry. They've been going through an incredibly difficult time. They've shown amazing resilience. They'll be relieved that Level 2 means travel restrictions are lifted and New Zealanders will be able to start to move around the country. Tourism industry Aotearoa have said that this will save thousands of jobs and hundreds of businesses. But I was listening to Susie Wilds speaking before me, and her point was very clear that we need to play it safe. There will still be restrictions around gatherings and physical distancing. So we're moving not back to normal, but back to a safer normal. But we're hearing the call of the tourism industry. We know that there is more work to do to support them.
OK, if we have to have social distancing, how will we fly? Do we have an answer for that yet under the Level 2 definitions? Will planes be able to be full, which will mean the price of tickets can be lower than if their capacity is 50%, for example?
Well, if you look at airlines, for example, they actually already do the things that we want. They've already they've got good contact tracing measures. They have been seating people. Decisions as to how full a plane will be up to them, because whatever we do, it has to be done safely. That's the main thing. And the government has been working with industries and associations to make sure that their members know exactly
can I cut in there, Minister? So you're saying the decisions are up to individual airlines, so planes could potentially be flying full once we're back in Level 2?
So it's making sure that they follow the guidelines, that everything we do safely. So there has to be the physical distancing.
So on one of those narrow planes that flies into our regions, let's say Gisborne or even Nelson, you can't have physical distancing when you're sitting side by side with someone, can you? Which means the planes won't be full. Is that what you're saying?
Well, it's going to be up to the airlines. You know, they have to make decisions based on what's good for their business. But the government isn't saying you must do this or must do that. We're saying that what you must do is, maintain the guidelines. You must make sure that there is physical distancing and that we are playing it safe, as Susie Wiles said.
Can we talk about what Mayor Rachel Reese was saying, the Mayor of Nelson, before the news at 7? And she was saying she believes that targeted wage subsidies for tourist operators need to continue really for the foreseeable future. Is that on the cards?
So we have discussions as a cabinet, obviously, about the measures that we've already put in place. And, you know, there was a $12 billion package that has supported businesses. And we have the discussions around what we need to do next. There is a budget coming up next week, which I can't preempt the outcome of that. But, you know, we are working on what we need to do to continue to support not just tourism, but all businesses in New Zealand.
We spoke to Well Watch Kaikoura on Tuesday, and they told us roughly 80% of their passengers are foreign tourists. So even if we all, those of us who can still afford to do so, embrace Level 2 and have New Zealand holidays and travel around the country, it's not going to be enough for some operators, is it? It's not going to cover their costs, it's not going to pay the bills, it's not going to keep all of their workforce in work. Is the government going to have targeted support for those tourism operators in the budget next week?
Yeah, and look, we're looking at all those sorts of things. I mean, there is a domestic campaign coming up. We will launch it at the right time. And we understand what they're saying. And there are operators like Whale Watch, for example, who are the key to that whole area. We've been having discussions around those lines. And like I say, I can't preempt what will come next week in the budget. But we are giving great thought to how we can best support members in the industry.
A total of roughly 400,000 jobs, more than half of them directly, about 40% indirectly, rely on us collectively getting this right. And I wonder, Are you providing the leadership the sector needs?
Oh, look, we've been working very, very hard in the background, making sure that we can put in place ways to support the industry. We've been working with Tourism New Zealand on looking at the future of tourism. We've got a goal ahead of us.
What is the goal?
Well, we're reimagining the future of tourism, and when we can see what the future of tourism, then we know exactly what needs to happen for us to get there. We've been engaging extensively with members of the industry. By the end of today, I'll have spoken to about 3,000 members of the industry.
What do they want? As a majority, what are they asking for?
Well, they're saying a number of things. One of the big things is they're saying we need to reimagine a more sustainable tourism future, but they're saying we also have to work together, we have to collaborate on this, that we have to engage with small businesses, with the regions and with iwi. But everybody's in this together, and, we understand that people are hurting, we understand that the industry has gone through a very rough time, and as a cabinet, we are working very hard to make sure that we support them.
Will you have something meaningful for them in the budget next week?
Well, look, as I've said, I can't preempt what's going to be said in the budget, but I have been feeding in the feedback from the tourism industry into my colleagues, and we're going to make sure that every dollar we spend is there to create jobs and support businesses.
Kelvin Davis, Tourism Minister, thank you so much for joining us this morning. We really appreciate your time, and we would love to get you back after the budget to discuss any initiatives that may or may not be in it.